Okay. So, a bit of music going. While we wait for the chat. Coding overload. Probably have to turn down the. Oh, we'll see. See how it all comes out. Let's get the chat up. We'll see if anyone's gonna join us. Keep getting encoding overloads. I'm gonna turn in the bitrate then. Okay. Make it so the music is able to be heard, even if it's not going to be very loud. I guess I should probably tweet this out that I'm doing this. Am I not actually live? Is live for a minute. Oh, I'm private right now. That's stupid. That'd be why. There we go. Go. Should be set up. I'll wait for people to start coming in. I can't believe I initially went live privately. Don't even know why that's a thing. So that's fun. Listen to some music. Use my favorite music playlist. Oh, it's such a good playlist. Ah, Sand Road. Check that everything's live. Do my shilling. Dang, is this Sand Hill or Persona Hill? So good. Okay. Well. Might as well get started pretty quickly here. Okay. I'll make sure I have the chat ready for people to actually chat. Okay. Well, might as well get going. So, I'm gonna pause the music while I do my spiel at the beginning. For the YouTube version. All right, hello everyone. Today I am building the Fate Grand Order Petitress model kit of Saber. I have four Petitress kits that I will be Doing over the next little bit, but of course got to start off with my king. So just going to be just casually building it. Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. And of course there'll be chat, so if you want to just casually chat with me, I'm here. Hi, Just for Temporary. Yeah, we're doing some model kits. Just something to do while I wait around for work, really. So I might have to swoosh away for a second, say that I have, you know, I have to take a phone call or something. But otherwise, yeah, we're just here and we're going to be doing just some building. I got snippers, which will be helpful. Oh, hey, thanks for the $5, Shiro. That's, I'm really not doing anything too much, so thank you so much for that. I didn't expect that. I think it's the first time I've ever had that on YouTube, at least. I'm trying to stay away from Twitch, just because might as well stick with just YouTube, but thank you so much. Didn't even know that was a function on YouTube there. Use it to buy more, maybe. Because the ones I have are... I have Saber. I have Nerocaster. I have... Miyamoto Musashi and Mash. So those are the ones that we'll be looking at in the future. The only reason I got Musashi, because originally I didn't get hers, but she was on sale on Amazon for like $5 for the model kit. So I was like, heck yeah, let's get that. Just literally free, pretty much, because I needed it for free shipping anyways, so. Hello, Edward and Bethany Anderson. Brittany, sorry. One of you, hello. We're building. What's up, Drip? I'm sure your name has been around quite a bit these days, what with the memes. This will be uploaded as a vid. Don't worry, Just for Temporary. You can come back. It'll probably be a little bit anyways, so. But yeah, this will be a vid, both fast-forwarded and in full, so you don't have to worry. Thank you for coming anyways. Just trying to be very careful, because I like to keep the boxes. Which, of course, these are like the worst boxes, because they are just very, like, they are the lightest cardboard imaginable. Okay, there we go. There we go. Not that many pieces, all things considered. Wow, yeah, this is quite simple compared to some of the other kits that I've done. So, hey, that's not a complaint. Some of those have been crazy. So I have the instructions here that I'll be looking at. Oh yeah, that's so much less than... I might actually do two of them today, because this is actually not a lot. Again, it's not a bad thing. Now, if you ever hear a Smash Bros. Symbol go off, or sound, that's just an email, so I gotta check. Okay, I'm all good. Just, you know, work stuff. Alright, so, I'll start with opening these up. Hello, Tanner, silent watch of your content. Really like the, Stay Night Hollow Ataraxia. Thumbs up, thank you. Oh, thanks, Jumpman! It's him. It's the Mario himself. Thank you so much. Yeah, those are very special. I even went back and clicked on one of my old Stay Night videos, and I'm like, wow, this is really good content. I made this? Me? What's up, Jose Bobadilla? Or Bobodilla, maybe? I'm not sure. Yeah, this is actually like way less than I thought it would be in terms of the pieces. I've done some big model kits, so... forgot I was gonna change my name. Good luck trying to pronounce this one. And this kid is really pog. Sokai 21? Sokie? Oh man, mean pronunciations. You know that. I'm not good at that. Let's see here. Just opening up this. Oh, that ASMR of the bag ripping open. I do like how the base The base for it, which you can like barely see, it's supposed to be like golden, but I have my ring light on. It's like the Excalibur around her. It's real good. Okay, so let's get started. C13. C13 is right here. I usually like to cut to get started a little bit, and then once I get one, then I can just pull off there. You got it right in the second time. Sokai. Oh, Sokai. Sounds good to me. Okay, so there's that one. Use modeling nippers, to get rid of excess sprue. Okay, we're good there. Combine them without creating a gap. Okay, so that's 13 and... Was it like more on the back? Okay, these are a little weird. I don't know how you pronounce your name. Funky Spas Alien. Hi, Sigmire of Katarina. And what's up, Mr. Inuhanyo123? How's it going, guys? Okay. So it says 13, but then it shows it snap. Oh, is the other part like... The instructions are like truncated, which is very strange. Oh, here we go. Okay. So I'll just follow it then. Okay. It says start with the face. Like I said, this will be a YouTube upload for those who aren't here. And it will also be, I'll do both a regular and a fast forwarded version, so. This is, again, one of four of these types of model kits that I have. Face. Now I need A8. This kit is C. I need A. Yeah, building streams are a lot of fun. They make you feel good. And plus, with some casual talking is always nice. How's the music sounding? Can you guys, like, hear it at all? If it's there, or if it's, like, not too quiet. Right now it's playing some... smooth Puyo Puyo music. Is it too loud, too quiet? Be nice to know. Hello, Ferris Luthfi. Okay, got that. So now we place... Music is at good volume. Sounds good. So we have our... Come on. Ring light too powerful. Let me turn it down. Oh, cool. Ring light busted. Ring light broken. Can't change it. Doing precision stuff? A little bit. There's a little bit of precision involved. Not a ton, but definitely a little bit. Okay, so we got to put on now her eyes. Oh boy, I should probably get some tweezers for this, because the worst part is stickers. Tsukihime playthrough soon. It's been announced. Don't worry. It's been announced. It's coming. It is just, I literally want to finish the one thing that I'm doing right now, and then after that, I was gonna do something else, but Tsukihime has to come first now. Okay, I'm gonna go grab some tweezers real quick, because I need them for the sticker placing, because I hate placing stickers, but there's a lot. Oh, what Tashiga Kita, I'm back. I got some tweezers now. So let's place these eyes very carefully. Now, it says to place them on top, which is strange, because normally I place them underneath and then put them in, but I guess it's because you have a little bit of the eyeliner, too. Okay. This is the worst. Okay, let's see here. Ah, I got it! Got it in one! Heck yeah! I'm just gonna move my ring light a bit. It's a bit too powerful. There we go. I'll make it better. Got it in one. What anime? What anime? That doesn't exist. Definitely not on my shelf right now. Definitely didn't pick it up for extra cheap because it was on sale. Hi, Loy. Yeah, people have definitely told me read the manga alongside, or rather, if not alongside, but like after, for Tsukihime. So I will definitely take a look at that. All right, she has eyes. She can see. Next step is, let's see. Now we got to put on the top part of her hair. So now it's all hair now. Okay, so the first one is A3. Which is like the bangs. Just make it so you can see a bit more. Bangs. I honestly thought I'd begin to Tsukihime after Fate Extra, but honestly at this pace, I kind of have to do it before. Just want Tsukihime be done so you can get some Melty Blood. Yeah, no, one of the reasons I really wanted to get through Tsukihime was that I can play Melty Blood in a way that I can understand what's going on. And I do, of course, plan to cover every iteration of Melty Blood because Actress Again, the one on Steam, is like the sequel. It's not like... It's not the original story. And so I hope to cover all the games with their stories. And plus, I'm a fighting game player, so I'd like to actually check out, like, you know, how it changes over time. Oh, no, trust me, I have Plus Disc and Kagetsu Toya, too. Those are both on my desktop. You know, see how that evolves as well. Because I am a fan of fighting games. So we'll definitely get to that. Okay, we got the back of her hair. We got her little bun. Little bun. I have literally no idea what Kagetsu Toya is other than it's just something that I got. Does her ahoge not go on right now? Really? Her ahoge does not get put on at this point? Are you serious? That's criminal, but her bow does. Well, at least that's cute. Thought it was another Garth apart. Nope. This is live, because that was recorded a while ago. Okay, so now we're going to go... Okay, so the bun goes on... Okay, so bow on bun. Okay, bow on bun. Bun on back. Okay, bun on back. We got our bun hair. And now we place... Look, it's What If Saber Was a Jimmy Neutron Character. I'm sorry, the lighting is so bad. I'm gonna rotate it away. There we go, that's so much better. Right there. And then put on this. Like, there's spot for it. Like, you can literally see. There's a hole in her head where it should go. I feel like I should be putting it on now. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna break the rules. Because I don't want to have to try and slide it in there after. Well, there is, like, literally the ahoge piece is like... It's like this, just this tiny strand right here. So I'm gonna need to cut that off. Oh, it's like so fragile. Okay. So, squeeze the head together, and then Hoge is on. There we go. Very important. I'm going to change the brightness here. Okay, let me see here. That's better. That's much better. Are you a frequent modeler for figures? I've actually have about 6 or 7 videos of me doing model kits. I've been doing the Mega Man X ones, which they're like this. You can't see, but they're like, you know, decently sized. So I've been doing those quite a bit, and those have a lot of instructions. Those ones are like full on kits, right? Versus this, which is a lot smaller. I have a beef with Jimmy Neutron after an action figure of his stabbed me in the head as a kid due to the pointy hair. That's amazing. Okay. On to the actual instructions now, because that was do the face, body. Okay. So now we're just going to have a little bit of a roly saber head there for a bit. Okay, I'm going to put that over there. So we need the back of her chest plate. Or breastplate, if you want to be funny. Just listen to some funky J-pop, city pop. This is Hitomi Toyama, Love is Competition. Which I guess it is. Move this up so you can see a bit more. Oh no, don't look at my crotch. Doing this right, because it goes. Okay, so the sticker is applied while assembling. Okay, so I need to go to sticker 2. Which one is sticker 2? Oh, wow. It's like tiny stuff. When you start the Let's Read of Tsukihime, please read the guide. Some people accidentally miss the first route. I have more than enough people that I think to let me know kind of what to do. Thankfully, I'm not too worried about that. How does this go? Oh, one is on the front. Okay, I see. Okay, so let's see here. So one goes on the front. Oh, this is super precise stickers. Oh man, this is like, I feel like I'm doing surgery on like a mouse. Which is why I'll never be a doctor, because this mouse would have died right there. Absolutely, the worst part of doing the models is stickers, because I'm bad enough with coloring in the lines. Stickers, are you trying to kill me? I just hear a lot of Japanese talking. What is that going on? Okay. Tanner, make sure you read how to install the game. I have it installed. It's on my computer. Don't worry. I even started it up to double check that it works. Yeah, there we go. We got that. Kind of. A little bit. Are you excited for Annie to be in Skullgirls second encore this year? I am. I'm also excited that Skullgirls might not die, even though Mike Z tried to kill the company. Because they got the other team working on it, the mobile team. So that's good. I was really worried that my favorite fighting game would die. Deckles are not easy to work with. Nope, they are not, because I'm still trying to get it on perfectly. It's going to be slightly off-center. She'll put on her shirt slightly sideways that day. Okay, now we got to do the one on the back, which will be easier, because it only has 2 thingies. Do you like the Prisma Ilia anime? So, yeah, a lot of people are like, oh, the manga is better. And I read the manga of season one after watching the anime of season one. And I agree, it's better. But at the same time, if I were to go backwards, then, you know, manga first, then anime, I'd be disappointed in the anime. But if I watch the anime first, I can enjoy the anime and then enjoy the manga afterwards. It's the smartest way of doing it. Yeah, Mike Z has always been a guy where it's like, you see what he's doing, you're like, ugh, one of these days, bud, you're gonna get in trouble for being an assertive nerd, let's say, and oh boy did he. So, I definitely excused it a bit as, oh, that's just who he is, and it's like, that's not right. Okay, sticker, stay down, I'm gonna have to hold it. What's the status of Autumn Games? Autumn Games has been dead for a while. It's now... I don't even know, actually. Okay. I just got an email. Let's see here. Is this work email? Okay, well, I'm going to start getting work email soon. I may be new, but mind some of the comments on previous videos. If Sackboy, A Big Adventure, had fate clothes, would you want to play as one of the servants? Absolutely. I'd play the whole game as my girl Saber, because she's my favorite. I own so much merch of her. It's almost scary. I literally was eating out of my official Saber soy sauce dish yesterday. I tweeted about it. All these stickers suck. They're so small. They're so small, they're not even sticking to what they're supposed to stick to. Which is fun. Okay, that's good enough for now then. Not the best, but I never said that this would be the best. I was at either 2018 or 2019, or 2018, 2017, and yeah, the booth people were like, Mike's here, but nobody's really talking, and oh, geez. Uh-oh. Okay, next up. B1 and B2. Oh, God, there's more stickers. Oh, no. Sorry, disembodied Saberhead, you're gonna have to move. Okay, so we got... Oh, that was at Anime Expo. Okay, I was like... Didn't say where, but yeah. Yeah. Man, remember conventions? Easily add details, use markers sold separately, and paint it. Okay, I'm not that artistic. Prediction for the next Smash DLC? I don't think a fate character will get in. I think who does potentially have a chance is Reimu from Toho. I think that would be one that would be cool, bring awesome music, bring bullet hell gameplay, which is an unrepresented genre to Smash. Representing doujin games while not necessarily condoning eroge, which is, I'm sure, Sakurai doesn't want to do. So. Yeah, it says, hey, are you having trouble with the stickers? Just draw them on yourself. And I'm like, I don't think I can do that. Oh, I hate when people just reply, okay, thanks. Let me just say I'm glad to see you getting to Tsuki Tanner. Most Type Moon fans don't even know what Tsuki... Well, okay, so here's the thing. How can Type Moon fans not know what Tsuki Hime is when look at the box? Do you see right there? It's gonna zoom in and have a hard time, I bet. Come on. There. It's Neko Arc, right there, on every single box. Every single one. Molded Silver should paint that. What do you take me for? Some type of artist? I'm a YouTuber. I YouTube because I don't have any other... anything. And plus, it'll match with my other molded-looking silver figures. Don't need her super shiny. If I wanted a shiny saber, I would just get Nero. Jokes. Okay. The drawing and painting is why I've kind of stayed... Honestly, I've never done one that I've needed to draw or paint. Those are how you make them look perfect. But honestly, they usually come with the stickers in a way that they can at least look good. You know? You don't need them to look like, you know, they won't ever look like the artwork of what the website you're buying them from. Actually, the Mega Man X one I got is pretty similar. That one is astonishing, even unpainted. It's actually better than there's a shiny version of it. I much prefer the opaque version. Okay. Sticker on. Mega Man X, in my opinion, has like the best character design ever. Like, I just love how he looks. Like, default X. Just like, that is perfect in my eyes. Squish on that sticker. So now we got on the front there. Okay, now we also got 5 and 6 in the corners. Oh, it's like kind of off center. Let me fix that. Oh, no, never mind. That's on. Okay. The Tsukihime trailer is hype. Yes, I've watched it. I know people said don't, but I did. Haha, fool. If I wanted a shiny saber, I'd watch Violet Evergarden. Okay, for real, I was like, when I went to the last anime expo, our local one, before everything went bad, I saw a bunch of, every time I saw Violet Evergarden, I'm like, it's Saber! No, wait, it's just that bitch Violet Evergarden. And my friend who saw Violet Evergarden was not very happy, because apparently it's really sad. I haven't watched it myself. Did I just make that sticker buckle in on itself? Well, shoot. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, no. When the sticker kind of collapses in on itself is the worst. Well, she'll have half a thing. How do you feel about the Persona OSTs coming to Spotify? I don't have Spotify, so it doesn't matter too much to me. Cool for people who want to listen to them, but I mean, I got my Persona 4 soundtrack with my copy of Persona 4, so I just listened to that. I ripped it myself, so yeah, that sticker's done. That's okay. That sucks. It's like the one on her neck. You wouldn't even see it anyways because of how her neck is, but it's just like, yeah. It just buckled in on itself. I'd have to draw it or something. I saw you're playing P5 on Twitter. Well, it's my second time because I played the original Persona 5. When it came out, it's definitely the better version, but at the same time, where I'm at right now, it is still mostly the same. Like, I'm waiting for the big sort of new stuff to start appearing. It's close, apparently. Okay. This is 5 goes on this side, and it goes this way. Oh my god. These precision stickers are the worst. How are you enjoying your PS5? It's an amazing console to play PS4 games on. Because right now there's not many PS5 games. I mostly bought it because I don't have a PS4 Pro. And some of the games I've been playing have started to like not work very well on my PS4, so I got it mostly for the upgrade, and, you know, future-proofing. How are you? Are you back in school as a teacher? I'm a sub, and so I'm not fully teaching right now. Like, today I'm on call pretty much as a tech person. That's why I'm doing this, because it gives me an excuse to just play around, and I have no idea how this sticker is going to go on. Okay, there we go. Oh my god, this is the worst. I am having absolute trouble with these stickers. Like, you can't see, but it's like they're these tiny, tiny, tiny things. And they're not even really sticky. I can't even tell what side is the side it's supposed to be going down either. Oh my god, and they keep falling on my fingers, and then my oil makes them unsticky. I'm an oily boy. Yeah, okay. I'm giving up on that one. Also, she's gonna have the one big sticker at the front, then that's it. Like, she'll have that one, and that's it. Because then you're like literally this tiny sticker. They're like the size of a pinhead. That's fine. I'm not that into the details.
Okay, just gonna stretch.
When you talk about the Mega Man series and think about the possibility of the next character in X-Dive, thinking it'll be Geostellar and Sonya Strum, I think that's like the, I mean, aside from Cross-Dive, not Cross-Dive, but the, Crossover is the only one that I could see. Are students watching your content? Nope, they don't know about it, because I keep my life separate. I keep my work life and home life separate. I mean, if there's been a time where one found it, and I just said, yep, that's a thing that I do. It's something I do in my own time. It's, I don't need to change myself. And that was it. So that was kind of how that went. Okay, so this is C10, 6, 9, and 4. So 10. Oh, let's cut this out. Yeah, I have big, dumb fingers, so I can't do stuff that is small and precise, which I know is kind of one of the major aspects of doing these, but that's fine. Yeah, petite Triss being small definitely doesn't help. There's that. And then 4... Only have a launch PS4, waiting for the PS5 Slim. I mean, there's probably going to be... I mean, I need it for Final Fantasy 16 right away, so that's why I jumped on it, like, right away. At least me, personally. But I understand not buying it at launch. I'm not like one of those people who's like, you're a fake fan if you don't buy your thing at... No, it's like, whatever. Let people do what they want. It's their money, dude. I really don't care that much to call people fake fans or anything. Okay, so this goes right here. Ah! It's okay, we're good. It's front. The front side is the one with the lines, okay? And this goes here. Got an arm. What do you think of Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite? It is my most favorite Marvel game to play. It has my favorite fighting game character to play as of all time, being Sigma. Sigma is, in my eyes, the most fun fighting game character ever. He just has everything in his kit that I love. Just a damn shame that the game is graphically the way it is. And when you look at the leaked roster for it, that was had about, you know, almost double the cast of Marvel vs. Capcom 3. But then it was rushed because of Endgame. A bit of a shame. Definitely a bit of a shame. But not much we can do about that, because that is Disney Corp's choice. So this goes right here. Most anticipated game of 2021? It'd need to be a game that I kind of know is coming out in 2021. I don't know. Right now, there's not too much I'm excited for. Hey, I call her Artoria all the time. It's called Altria on there, so that's why I called it Altria. I don't know. Most anticipated 20... Honestly, like, if it's coming out this year, Fate Extra Record is going to be amazing. I'm just excited for that, but... let's see here. What do you think about a hypothetical Type Moon and Arc System Works collab? I would cry. It's not gonna happen. And if I were to do it, then they'd take my videos down and try to destroy my channel again. Thanks, Arc System Works. Love to see it. I have a bit of a beef with them when they try to destroy my channel, so... See, I'd say I'm excited for Tsukihime, but I can't read it because I don't read Japanese. And so let's hope that they get that fan translation done in a decent amount of time. All right, we got the big gauntlet. That's important. Hello, Chaos to Steel. Next up is B6 for her hand. Yeah, these are very much like beginner kits, aside from the stickers, which are like pure platinum level difficulty. Got that, so that's one arm done. So now, honestly, we can like... I know they say to not attach them until after, but oh, the stickers are already coming off. Part of a body. Okay, now we gotta do the same thing again. That's my least favorite part about model kits, is the fact that you have to do both sides. Like, you have to do both arms. Hollow Moon will most likely translate Tsuki Remake in a flash. Most of their members grew up with it. Yeah, but the problem is... The big problem is the fact that they have to, like, reprogram a PS4 and or Switch game. There's no PC version, so that's gonna be fun. You ever check out Gunpla? I've done Gunpla once because I went to the Gundam base in Odaiba City in Tokyo, and because I was there on vacation, and so I actually ended up buying a limited run Gundam girl there. So I did on this channel. I think there's a thing of it. So there's a video of me building the Gundam base exclusive Super Fumino. So that's fun. Quite a nice little kit there. Very pretty easy, which is nice. I personally, Gundam is like one of those things that I just missed out on because it was on too late for me as a kid, and unlike Dragon Ball, it never got reruns to be sort of shown always. So, bit of a shame, but at the same time, hey, there's always something I can check out later, I guess. Okay, so now let's put this one on. I'll be honest, if there wasn't for COVID, I would absolutely be already looking for another trip to Japan right now, because God, it was the best. It was just, what a wonderful time. I'm currently having the MG ball. Oh, I don't even know what that is. Oh, Master Grade. Oh, like the ball guy? Oh, yeah. Just to say, never bring up pure platinum because I almost died 2 times on Jubileus non-stop. Oh. That's one of those things where it's like, I love Bayonetta 1 and 2, but like, some of those secrets, I'd never get. I don't have the patience to be Hideki Kamiya powerful. I have a job, man. The only Gundam I've actually watched are... G Gundam, which is perfection. It's Street Fighter with robots in space. And I watched, when it was on TV at an earlier time slot, SD Gundam Force, which I'm sure fans love, obviously. So that was something that I got to at least experience that. Okay, now we're going to do the other arm, which is... one. Oh, her other arm is just one big piece. Interesting. Super Nintendo Gundam spin-offs as a kid. Toonami. Yeah, that's a thing. Toonami isn't a thing in Canada, so we only had what was on at YTV, and YTV would air stuff pretty late. Thankfully, YTV has to air mostly Canadian content, and guess what Gundam is? It's dubbed in Canada. So... They gave it a pass, and we could have that on our TV. So that's good there. Okay, we got a body. Cool. So now we need her legs. Okay. Well, I watched SD Gundam Force as a kid because it was airing on, like, again, actual TV here. But then G Gundam I watched later when my big Gundam friend fan, big Gundam fan friend, rather, recommended it to me as, like, a good beginning one, which it was. I really enjoyed it. I didn't watch all of it. I watched, I think, about, like, 16 episodes, which is a good amount for me. Plus, where I live, we actually live not far from the studio that they dub the Gundam stuff in. And my said friend actually auditioned to be in some dubs of Gundam before they stopped dubbing Gundam. So, at least here locally. RIP Canadian dubbing companies, we miss you. I actually run into, I'm mutuals with the voice of Zero from the Mega Man X cartoon, or Mega Man X games, not the new one, not Johnny Young Bosch, but before that, Brendan Hunter. He comes up a little bit. Did you see more of Ocean Dub or Funny Dub? So I saw a lot. So I had like a weird moment where, like, I loved what I watched of the Ocean Dub. And then one day I went to my friend's house to play one of the video games, and I remember hearing the Funny Dub cast and going, that's not the right people. Why do they sound wrong? And then later on, when I went to watch Dragon Ball, it was the Funny Dub. So for a long time, I thought it was crazy and made up this fake version of Dragon Ball in my head. But no, it was just because it was the, I heard Ocean Dub, and then it kind of disappeared on me and then became the Funny Dub. So yeah, it was terrifying to have my whole life almost shattered, thinking that this Dragon Ball version, I heard it wrong this whole time. So we got her leg. How the heck does that connect? Oh, this goes here. Oh, there we go. That's a leg. That makes sense. Did you watch the... I didn't watch much Dragon Ball because it was on late and my parents didn't like the violence in it. So I didn't watch any Dragon Ball really aside from random episodes until I was older there. Oh, thanks for the... thanks for the 3... Euros, my Kira? That's what that symbol is, right? Thank you. It's going pretty good. I'm having a decent time here. That said, I have no clue how these legs are going to attach, actually. I need to take a look after. Okay, so let's get the other leg. Yeah, so I didn't get to see much of it. It was only really started getting into Dragon Ball once DBZ Abridged kind of started off, just because then I was like, I started watching it and went, oh yeah, I remember watching Dragon Ball as a kid quite a bit, and I enjoyed it. And then I was like, okay, let's actually go back and watch Dragon Ball, and then I watched Kai. Ocean just stopped dubbing up to 53. Yeah, they switched off who kind of had the rights to it. That said, what I remember more is the Canadian Dragon Ball opening, like the actual, what it sounded like. There was, it's so good. It's just Dragon Ball Z. It's so good. It's so bad, it's good. I loved it. Speaking of which, hi Goku fangirl, you came at a good time. We're talking Dragon Ball, even though I'm doing Fate figures. Okay, so we got that. Resumes on the back, so we got more. Oh yeah, DBZ Abridged is way more fun. It's really fun. Yeah, okay, so I'm gonna definitely get to the Unlimited Blade Works Abridged, because I saw some clips of it, just a few on Twitter, and they look really fun, so I will definitely get around to watching Unlimited Blade Works Abridged there. Seems quite funny. I'm doing pretty good. Thanks, Goku fangirl. Just doing some building. I'm on call at work right now, so I'm getting these out of the way. Making I bought all these and then I said, I'm going to do them on camera. And then it just never came around to it. And then I realized, oh, I should probably do that right now. Hi, J-Chan. I can see Nintendo make a remaster of Kid Icarus Uprising with three sides of the main story, new types of weapons, one of the allies playable in all the levels. Yeah. It was always weird to me that Magnus was only in one level and that you couldn't play as him in kind of all of them. I would like to see him as a side mode, you know. Enjoying my Crisis Core gameplay, thank you. I'm enjoying Crisis Core as well. It's a fun game. Do I really need to put a sticker on her underwear? Like, for real? Which one is asking for? Which sticker is that? 4. No, that's okay. Oh, wait, no. Or, no, it's not a sticker for her underwear. Okay. It's like that part, it's a white part that you paint silver. Okay. I thought it was going to be putting it on her underwear, which makes no sense. I'll never pick her up. I support her as a woman. Dang. Oh my goodness. Saber got a dumpy. It's not canon. She's supposed to have a tiny bony butt. That's not right. I know, I've seen all the CGs in the game. It's supposed to be small and bony. Okay, so this one goes right here on the back. Crisis Core, yeah, I'm enjoying it. It's definitely a fun look at the Seven Universe with a much more energetic and fun character than Cloud. Whenever I see people draw Saber with a big butt, I'm like, you're wrong. Does not look like that. Glad people are picking up Crisis Crafter. Yeah, it's nice to sort of see it's making people want to check him out. Takeuchi can also not draw abs because in-game they're like, Shiro, how can you love me when I'm so freaking shredded? And you're just like, what? You having super muscles is amazing. I love it. Like, how could that be a bad thing? I love your muscles. And then you look at the art and she has no muscles. And you're like, what? When I was in Japan, I actually saw, I went, cause I had, just listen, but I had to go to a doujin shop in Japan because I wanted to buy Fate Stay Night, the actual game, because that's the only place you could buy it, because it's technically R18, right? And when I was there, I looked in the Fate Doujin section, and they had one which was literally, like, the cover is just Saber ripped with muscles. And I'm talking, like, she is ripped with muscles. Like, massive. And I'm like, yeah, that's awesome. Then I open it up, and it's just really gross porn. So I was like, don't like that. I like the cover, but not enough to get that. So that's my story about saber muscles that I saw in Japan. Okay, so we'll attach the legs. Well, because I wanted to buy my own copy of Fate Stay Night, right? And so to do that, I needed to go into stores that were a bit unscrupulous. Oh, more ripped than Emya. Like, I'm talking huge muscles. I was kind of worried about picking up anything. Like, okay, so there's, like, rules about coming back into Canada about what you can import, and one of the things it says is you cannot bring in pornography from other countries to Canada. So when I was coming over the border, I was like, okay, I cannot make sure. I need to make sure that they don't, you know, question anything that I, you know, that I bought, right? And I was a little worried because, of course, like, I bought the original Stay Night, which is technically pornographic, right? Because the scenes that are in it. And so I actually came up with, like, a whole script in my head for what do I do if I'm stopped by the border patrol because I brought this game that is R18. And I was literally gonna, like, I came up with a whole script of this is academic. I look at it, you know, like I look at it for academic reasons. Note that it is not, you know, I literally read through the rules and it says like if it's for artistic purpose. So I was like, I really went in. They didn't even look at my luggage. So it doesn't even matter. But I was like, I came up with like this whole thing to make sure that I could get my fate there. So I didn't want to risk it with anything else. Okay, so we need the dress. It's just definitely one of those things that I went there, I wanted it, you know? And I wouldn't stop till I got it. That thing was like $100 too. But it was worth it to own a real copy of Stay Night. Which, of course, it's funny, though, because I say own a real copy. It's a digital code. There's no even disc in there. But it does come with one of the art books. And it's nice to just physically own, you know, the thing that I really enjoyed. I'm the type of person that, like, if I'm going to pirate a game, like, to emulate it or something, I'm going to buy a real copy of it to also have, just so that I'm not worried about, you know, feeling bad. Okay, so we need to attach the dress to her butt. Attach this part to her front. Okay. There we go. Yeah. Hey, she can stand. That's pretty good. Okay. Now we have to do the whole... Ooh, her whole, like, everything. Okay, I'm gonna put that to the side. Now, the question is, do I put on her coat and, do I put on her coat and her crown? It's tough, because while I dislike it, I already took the coat and the crown off of my Nendoroid of her, so I think this one I'll put it on. Enjoyed your Fate Let's Play so much, especially when you mentioned how much you hate Shinji. Oh yeah, oh, it was good. I brought my sister to go see Heaven's Feel in theaters, which was great, being at her not knowing anything about it. And when we went to see it, she basically said, like, I hate Shinji so much. And I'm like, I'm glad you understand. You know exactly what I'm on about.
More stickers. Oh, that's a pain in the butt, this one. I don't like the crown. I don't like the crown on her. It looks gaudy. I like the fact that, like, she only subtly represents King Arthur. Right? Like, I don't want it to be just out and apparent, but... Oh well.
Did you watch the third movie? Yes, we saw all three in theaters. She got her payoff and was very happy. Because we watched the first two as a double feature, and then we saw the third a week later. Ironically, now all the theaters are closed down, so it's like it's gone. Like, that was the last thing I'll ever see in theaters. It's a shame, because I want to see the other new stuff in theaters. I want to see Camelot. I want to see all that. There's also, like, no one there, because it was still mid-pandemic. But that means that we got a private showing. It's pretty dope. There are some cool differences. They did a really cool thing. I don't want to spoil it, but they did some really cool things with some of the differences. There's one thing that they did with Sakura, which I really enjoyed as a difference between the thing there. Oh yeah, and the fight themes, or fight the scenes were amazing. So, like, the fight scenes are amazing. Yeah, no, Fate Stay Night is one of my favorite stories of all time.
I still say the best version of it is the visual novel, of course, because that is the proper way, I think, of reading it. However, like, those are still great adaptations, and are really good. Recommended to everyone. Just don't put on the porn scenes. I just got to see the Fate movie in theaters, but I'm going through the VN on my own channel. I live in Florida, so I don't want to catch COVID. Yeah. Yeah, no spoilers. Don't worry. I'll stay away from them. Yeah, but I'll just say, like, overall, I definitely enjoyed each of the movies. I thought they sequentially got better, which is not a popular opinion, but I stand by it. Ooh, that one went on, like, perfect. I feel good. 5... Yeah, it is exactly what you're thinking about. You got that one. Another part done. 14. Check my emails to make sure I'm not getting flooded with, because literally right now I'm in the process of being a tech guy for people trying to access new email accounts. So far got nothing. Fate was one of the last Tight Moon properties. So yeah, like, it's, I heard of the other stuff before, but I don't even remember why I started Fate, other than I saw someone post on, I don't even remember where they posted, but they posted somewhere and were like, hey, check out the, here's a download to Fate Stay Night. And I thought, sure, might as well download it. And then I started Let's Play, and all of a sudden I'm like, oh my god, I love this. Thoughts on Fate Zero. Haven't read the novel. I have all the released manga, but obviously that's not, they didn't finish it, so I didn't get to read it all. But from what I have read, I enjoy it. Or rather, what I've watched. I thought it's a cool sequel, or prequel. Well, it's kind of a sequel, honestly. I think people who say to start with it are insane. I think that it's one of those things where you need to enjoy the first and then get the information second, you know? Because anyone who says you should read stuff in chronological order are insane. Like, go in release order always. Like, there's never... Like, the only time I can think of that it works better to go, kind of chronological is Yakuza, because of the fact that it... Yakuza 1 starts in media res, so to actually get the backstory of Kiryu is pretty cool. But otherwise, yeah, no. Have you checked out Fate Strange Fake? I have it downloaded on my phone, the novel translation, but I haven't actually read it yet. So I'll be doing that later on there. Are you going to watch Carnival Phantasm after reading Tsukihime? Yes. Now, Strange Fake, you say Strange Fate after Tsukihime. I think my plan is going to be book club style. So it'll be, I won't do live readings because there's so many live readings of them. And I don't think people would like my live reading where I would make comments. So I think it would be, all right, you know, this week we're reading chapter 1. So then we'll talk about it. And then we'll come back with chapter 2. Try Prototype. I did read one chapter of Prototype, but not as myself.
I read it as Funky Kong, my dude, ASMR.
I'll definitely be reading more of that later, although, I mean, the fact that it's a Prototype prequel and there is no real Prototype, that's kind of wild. Thoughts on Benny Emma? Thought Benny Emma was a little boy, didn't know Benny Emma was a little girl, so that surprised me.
I actually use her Noble Phantasm and full moveset in an upcoming video, so you'll get to see my reactions, but overall, yo, Benny M is pretty cool, so. I love this playlist. I remember watching your... Yeah, my Fate Extella video is wild. It's like an alternate universe version of me. It's insane. The original Fate Extella one, the stream, it's weird. Yeah. Fate Grand Order Arcade has the same amount of characters. Man, that's the one thing. I played Grand Order Arcade in Japan, and it was so fun, and I'm never going to be able to play it again. Makes me sad. Ah, trying to put these pieces together. So this goes in like right here. There we go, we got that. The butt piece on. So this goes to the front. I don't think Hollow Ataraxia needs an anime because I've been informed that some of the scenes about the spray park scenes and stuff, those are actually in the Emiya Gohan anime. So hey, that's cool. I feel like Hollow Ataraxia could be, if they want to do just the main story, could be a really good single OVA. But, I don't know. I think part of what makes Hollow Ataraxia special is the fact that it plays with, like, the concept of visual novels and repeats and wanting to do events and stuff. So, although there is one wild OVA for an anime that literally would... Oh god, I remember seeing it. It was like, it was an OVA for an anime that when you hit play on your Blu-ray player... or DVD player, it would then pick random scenes and make a new viewing experience every time. I remember reading this and there's literally a flow chart for this anime OVA where it's like only after like three randomized rotations could you get the true ending of the OVA. Like, it was wild. It was so cool. Like, that's really cool. That could work out for like a Hollow Ataraxia there, you know, but that's, just my opinion. I will say the stinger of Prisma Ilias Season 1 would get me unbearably hyped if I didn't know that she was already in, thanks to the cover of the Blu-ray. Like, yo, it's her! It's my first time seeing her animated. Can't get that in. Just one sec. Got a text. There we go. All right. Dress is made. Okay, I just have to take a phone call quickly, guys, so I'll be back momentarily. Just pop over. Okay, I'm back. Hi, everyone. Sorry about that. Just had to do some work-related stuff, so... Oh, boy. Hey, at least you gotta listen to some funky tunes. Just gotta type this up. But anyways, I'm here. Is there anything better than, like, funky disco music? So good. Okay, but never mind. Para para music is also really good. Large fan of the para para genre. Okay, just gotta post this. Okay, so let's finish this girl up. Okay. It's one of the reasons why I don't love streaming is I almost always get interrupted and have to do something else. It is a shame, but it is something that I just live with, living my rather hectic life. Working 2.5 jobs and all that stuff. But I do it for the gacha money. Do it for the gacha. Okay. So now let's go. Body on. Alright. Head attached. Oh my god, it's her. But we're not done yet, of course. Actually, she stands up really well for these type. Like, wow. She's very sturdy for these figures. Make her look up. There we go. Make her look right at the camera. Okay, looking up is a little hard with her, because then she kind of falls backwards. There we go. Yeah. It's a good thing she does have a base, because she would fall over otherwise. Okay, now. Please be careful. Okay, so it literally warns you that her ahoge is sharp. That's hilarious. Oh, you know why they didn't do the ahoge right now? Because they want you to put the crown first and then the ahoge. Ah, I see. So we gotta turn her into altar for a sec. Yoink, you've been altered. Let's put on Number 15, Burger King Fate Saber. The last thing you want in your Burger King is the King of Britain eating a nasty hamburger. Is that meme too old now? Might be. Okay. Oh, hey, there we go. Yeah, for some reason my chat was not updating, so I clicked on it, and then it immediately all updated. Let's see here. Loved your zero reactions to the H scenes. Yeah, that's fun. I'm looking forward to the fact that there is no alternatives in Tsukihime. You have to include them. There we go, look. It's Burger King Saber. She's ready to fight. Get those chicken fries. Oh god, Burger King chicken fries are the best. I love them so much. I would slay a man for a Burger King chicken fry. Okay, where's the blue? new set right here. Okay, time for the cape. So blue's done, put that away. Okay, so we got some more stickers. Don't remind, yeah, because I've heard that the Tsukihime H scenes are the actual worst, like ever. Which is amazing because I thought you couldn't get worse than Stay Nights, so. I'm excited but terrified. Which is a fun combo. So we got, we need to put the clasp on. I do like her cape. It's just specifically the little crown I don't like too much. But her cape is cute. There you go. And then we got 18 and 19 on the corners of the back. It's like the... Or is it like... Oh no, it's right there. It's at the front. I do find it funny that until people told me that you can just toggle like the H scenes on for Stay Night, I actually had to go to... pornography websites for them. Actually, that's where I had to get most of like the assets for Stay Night, because like when I make my thumbnails, I would have to like get the assets kind of extracted, and to do that I would need to go to bad places for them, let's say. Like, look, if I want a place with all the CG in like nice style, it's got to be a site that's not good. Ironically, that's also where I had to get my copy of Stay Night, was from a basement porno shop in Akihabara. And they gave me lube with it. For, as a free gift. Thank you, sir, but I'm not using it for that. I am reading it and enjoying it as a piece of media. It's not even a joke. I don't need to make jokes. I just talk about real things that happen to me, and they're funny enough on their own. Yeah, we got the that. Yeah, I also got a rather large poster with it, which was in the background of some of my videos. So it's like Saber and Rin both in Cheong Sam's. So. Looks cute, little too etchy. Do I still have it? I still have it. Right at hand. Who are you looking forward to in FGO? My boy, the man, the myth, the legend, Masamune. Okay, so we got that. So we got it. We got to remove the head of Saber. I'm sorry. It's not just it's special stuff. It's not just regular. It has a whole descriptive thing. In English, if I'm correct, too. It's all in English, which is wild. New adult concept. Be positive, be smart, be free. Pleasure the way it should be. Clickball. And the back's all in Japanese. I can't show the back. But like the front is like all in English and all fancy. Like it's like very fancy. It's amazing. Last thing we have is we can either decide I'm gonna leave this up to you guys, because again, it's an either or situation. Should I give her golden glowing sword or regular silver sword? Oh, that was Stain Coon, yeah. Makes sense. Everything makes sense now. So this is the golden glowing sword, or we give her, we can put the design on to make it look normal. It is up to y'all. Let's get a consensus. Okay, we got one glow. We got two gold. Well, two gold, one design. Now, what I will say is my Nendoroid for her, I have the invisible air on, because I think that looks so rad. Let her shine. Okay, it looks like the majority are saying gold. Let her shine. Okay, gold it is, for sure. Alright, that makes my life hella easier because I don't need to deal with putting on the sticker. Thank you all. Okay, so let's give her... Okay, so I want to have her do the pose. So we're gonna flip the arm upside down. Oh no, it's like this. And then it has her going down. And then we can have her hold... Oh, that looks good. Yeah, that looks good. And then she puts it this way. To anata wo master ka. Okay. There we go. Got that. Now we put... we have a little stand thing for her, so we're gonna put this here. Have you seen the Kara no Kyokai movies? No, but I do have them. I have the full box set. Yes, the like $400 box set I bought because I'm horrible. But I have it, and that is definitely on my list of to watch stuff. All right, so let me just get her posed up. It's not exactly perfect for the pose I want her to do. I need to have her put it down more. There we go. Is this the Mappy theme? Oh my god, it's an anime version of the Mappy theme. Oh my god, I love the stuff that comes on shuffle. That's incredible. Alright, anyways. There we go. So we have here our saber. She is ready. She is quite small. You can use the hilt stickers for blue accents. Oh. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, you're right. You're right. Let me put the hilt sticker there. I only really need it on the one side because she's just going to be facing it forward. Yeah, forgot about that. Ah, yeah, there we go. That's better. Now it has the base at least. Okay. So, you know what? Just for comparison's sake, I'm gonna go grab the Nendoroid so you can sort of see the size comparison. So this is the Nendoroid, and this is the Petite Triss. So as you can see, they are, well, roughly the same height. Just different proportions, really. You know? So yeah, actually I have like kind of like the invisible air becoming uninvisible is the one I chose, which looks real cool. In terms of which I prefer the design of, I think I definitely still prefer the design of the Nendoroid. I think the face is a bit more expressive. That said, this is like a quarter of the price and you do get to build it yourself, which is kind of fun. The downside are the stickers are the worst. Some of these stickers are so ridiculously tiny that you really need to get in there and make it small. So tweezers are recommended. But yeah, that was a nice little fun thing. Like I said, I'm gonna go get my other ones to show you. So I'm sure coming up in the next little bit, we also have a Musashi kit to do. I'm sure you can see very well. You got her. I have the Neurocaster, so we'll do that one sometime in the future. And then this one, so the other two I bought like locally. I got Musashi off of Amazon. The other two I bought from a local store. And then this one I ordered straight from Japan. It's like the box is like destroyed, which is, it's fine because it's all just like flat pieces. So whatever. But I was like, man. So yeah, but then we got MASH later on. So yeah, that was me taking a look at building this. Overall, I'd say ease of build is about a 4 out of 5. Like everything is really easy aside from the stickers. The quality, I would say, is also a 4 out of 5 because it still looks really good, even unpainted and stuff. Like it looks quite nice. The stickers actually add a lot of detail when, even though I didn't put them all on, but like half the breastplate is covered by her arms anyway. So those ones that I lost, doesn't matter. Yeah, that's pretty good. I enjoyed that quite a bit. So in the future, we'll be doing some more of these, probably just at another moment's notice. So thank you all for watching, and yeah, have a great Monday, everyone. Time for me to go to work. Ciao.